Hi, I'm Steve, and welcome to Patriot Bars Behind the Scenes. Now, I won't lie, I'm a home workout guy. See what I did there with the little rhyme? Well, anyways, moving on. Now, a guy who works out at home is oftentimes referred to as a cellar dweller, derogatorily. Yeah, you see what I mean. But anyways, one of the things that always frustrated me about commercial gyms, and one of the main reasons that I decided to work out at home, was so that I could do things my way, so I didn't have to follow someone else's rules.
You either follow my rules or follow my rules.
You know, because at a commercial gym, you're basically limited to using the equipment that they have on hand, mostly machines, which I hate, by the way. Yeah, sorry, didn't mean to offend or trigger anybody there. That's just my personal opinion, but it's how I feel. Now, believe me, I tried working out on the machines at the gym, and I always hated them, at least the weight stack ones. Now, treadmills, I'm actually okay with those, because if you need to run when the weather's bad, it's snowing or raining, or if you're like me and you live in a state of long, cold, harsh winters, well, then the treadmill makes sense. I live in Michigan, USA, by the way. But back to the machines, the weight stack machines, they never really did anything for me other than confuse me and frustrate me. Now, I know there's a lot of free weights at most gyms, and maybe a couple of squat racks or bench press stations, but usually not nearly enough for everyone who wants one.
That's bullshit.
Yeah, my thoughts exactly. And you ever go into a typical gym during a crowded time, like after working hours, you know, maybe 6 or 7 o'clock, you know, when most people have time to get their workout in before their dinner, and see the lines, see how crowded it is? Yeah, shock and disappointment are the norm.
Have dinner, ready?
No, not what I meant, but to continue. Well, I always had an interest in calisthenics as well. Now, very obviously, I'm no calisthenics expert. You know, like Daniel from Fitness FAQs or Chris Heria or what have you. And I don't claim to be.
You're basic.
Well, maybe I am, but I'm not going to lose any sleep about it. So, moving on. Now, I have a bit of a martial arts background. And they always had us doing push-ups and bodyweight squats, you know, mostly Hindu squats and Hindu push-ups and stuff like that. Probably out of convenience, because, you know, you only need the floor for that, and they always had a lot of kids or teenagers or adult students or what have you. And they're all, you know, doing that stuff on the ground because you don't need much equipment for that. It saves money for the business. So anyways, that martial arts background with a lot of push-ups and bodyweight squats and such, well, that's how I was brought up, so to speak, how I was taught to train, if you will. So I never was a weights-only guy, as I'm sure you can tell.
Down right there.
But honestly, I found it very hard to do any calisthenics at all in most commercial gyms. You know, little to no space on the floor to do sit-ups or push-ups, and if I actually could find a space, on the floor, it was usually pretty dirty, pretty gross.
Yeah.
Not to mention the gym was usually crowded. So if I hit the floor for a few sit-ups or what have you, I was always worried that someone would accidentally step on my face or something like that, you know. So it never worked out too well. Most of the time, there was only one pull-up bar, and it was usually, the one in the middle of the cable crossover machines. Where they attach to each other in the middle between the cable machine stacks. And it wasn't even a straight bar most of the time. It was usually a wonky or angled pulling surface. So that frustrated me. And it started to get expensive. You know, when I was younger, for a while, I had to have two gym memberships at the same time. One to the martial arts gym and one to the traditional gym so I could, I work on strength training too. And I would have to drive or ride from one to the other, sometimes both at the same, both on the same day, so that really started to chew up my time and my cash. So between the expense, inconvenience, and frustration, finally I got fed up and decided that I was going to work out at home. And naturally, if I was going to work out at home, I was going to need equipment to work out with. I started small first, some adjustable dumbbells. I think I had the Bowflex kind, which I got free from my aunt because they were a little too heavy for her. I had a couple of kettlebells I bought from a local sporting goods store, and I went shopping for a decent pull bar. Oh, and I was doing dips at the time too, but I was doing them just on two folding chairs. I'd stack little folding chairs up on the ground, bend my knees, and just do them like this the best I could. But as far as pull-up bars go, I couldn't find anything that was sturdy enough for what I needed. I bought one of the flimsy, cheap, foreign-made freestanding pull-up bars from another local sporting goods store, but no go on that one. It didn't work well for me. So for my second attempt, I tried the kind of pull-up bar that attaches to the door frame, and also beats it up. But, no luck there. Wasn't very versatile. Now, for my third attempt at finding a good pull-up bar, and it took me a long time to find this because I had to search around on the internet, but I bought the kind that high school and middle schools use in gym class. And I mounted it to the ceiling in my garage. And it was by far the best of the three, but it still wasn't versatile enough for my needs. And I couldn't move it around because it was bolted to the ceiling. So no go on that one either. So bottom line is, nothing that I ever tried was good enough when it came to pull-up and dip bars, and I was starting to get really frustrated about it. Now, I think you can see where this story is going. I decided to get to work on the problem, and that's how Patriot Bars was born. Now, nobody wants to hear me chatterbox all night, so I won't bore you with all the... Yeah, exactly. So anyways, fast forward a few years, and now we have the Patriot Pull-Up Bar, which is without a doubt one of the strongest and most feature-rich American-made pull-up bars out there. And it comes in two varieties, the standard issue for commercial gyms or areas with high ceilings, and the LCH model. LCH stands for low ceiling height, by the way. And that one can fit into areas with low ceilings, like residential homes, garages, or even some basements. Now, I'm not telling you that you should cancel your gym membership and convert your house into a gym and start ripping out the chandeliers for pull-up bar and barbell clearance and whatnot like I did, but to each their own, right? Ignore him.
You're beginning to irritate me.
Yeah. I've got to stop breaking the third wall here, guys. I'm going a little crazy. All right, you know what that means? We stop dragging you know what, and we get some training done here. I hurt my arm a while back, and it's not completely back to normal, so I have trouble pulling on a straight bar. But these Kintsugi Swissies put my hands into a neutral position that doesn't hurt. Gym rings will accomplish the same mission. The chin-up grip still works for me. No pain in this move. I discovered an interesting new way to do hanging leg raises. It works the obliques way. Notice I took the time to put on some footwear. The last thing you want to do is bang your feet up unnecessarily. Also, I like to work out barefoot, as you can see.
Can I just go barefoot?
I don't usually use my kettlebells the way you're supposed to. You know, swings and snatches and Turkish get-ups and whatnot. I usually just use them as weight handles like that. But what can I say? I'm unsophisticated. Not the most flattering looking exercise, I'll admit, but a great addition to your push-ups and weighted push-ups. Now, I wouldn't want you to get bored, so let's say we rock out some Bush. Can't forget about her legs. Pull-up bar honestly won't help all that much. So time to grab the kettlebells. You know, my legs have never been all that strong, but it's my fault for not working them harder. As you can see, I'm struggling here with relatively light weights, and I failed on that last rep. But you know, this is Patriot Bars, not pussy bars.
Language.
So, no excuses. We soldier on. Remember this, folks. Fitness isn't just for the elites. It's not for a special group of people only. It's for everybody. So remember that if anybody at the gym or wherever tries to look down on you for lifting less weight than them or maybe being less big or strong than them, whatever. And remember, guys, in some gyms, the majority, and I hear alarming stats like 80% of 80% of the dudes are on steroids anyway. You know, I sure as hell am not.
Steve, you said a bad language word.
You know, I'm old school. I still think that's cheating. Mark my words, if you take them, drugs will destroy you in the end. Now, if you take them, you may benefit now. If you consider telling your balls not to produce their own testosterone, you consider that a benefit. And you know, maybe you will get bigger and stronger, but you'll also probably die of a heart-related condition in your 50s or something like that. You know, and there are so many performance-enhancing drugs out there now, PEDs they call them, that a non-druggie like me can't possibly even keep track of all that shit. You know, what drug does this? What drug does that? What's legal? What's not? You know, who friggin' cares? It's all garbage, okay? You know, and sorry for the language, folks. I get a little fired up about this stuff. Hopefully, you put the kids to bed already, if you have them. I don't. Well, anyways, thanks for joining me tonight. I hope you enjoyed the video, maybe got something out of it. Do you have a second? Maybe you could...
Do you have a second to eat my farts?
This is Steve from Patriot Bars, signing off. Train hard, God bless America, or wherever it is that you happen to live, my friend.
Pretend to listen to me every word I say. You've been all up over me, all up in my space. Back off, back off. It's gone wild, let you walk all over me. Let you get the upper hand, but not for long, you see. And now you're in a position I wouldn't wanna be. Back off, back off. You can try to minimize me, but here's the truth. I've been saving all my savage up just for you. I'm ready for combat, ready for rage. Truth. I've been saving all my savage up just for